Welcome to the first video on Microsoft Bot Framework. This video is really just to set the scene, introduce you to some sort of key concepts, the services that you're going to be using, and the development story that you're going to be using to develop and configure your application. So the first thing that I want to show you is the Bot Framework website. So if you head over to get this out of the way. If you head over to dev.botframework.com, this is kind of the jumping off point for everything that you need to do in Bot Framework. You've got a few links at the top, and I'll sort of explain what each of these are in a moment. But first of all, if you click on documentation, you can see here we've got a good level of documentation, sort of covering every functional area of Bot Framework. You can see that there's documentation for the .NET Bot Builder and also the Node.js library for Bot Builder as well. This set of videos is focused on .NET, but if you are a Node.js developer, the same concepts apply to Node as well. So you can come back to this site and you know read through this documentation at your own pace. So the first thing I want you to do is click on the Bot Builder for .NET and Getting Started. So you click on that. This will basically give you a summary of all the things you need to do to get up and running. I want to sort of call out two key points. First of all, you'll need the bot application template. It's a Visual Studio template that you can download from this help page, and also the Bot Framework connector, which is an application. Again, you can download it from this web page. Okay, so let's have a look at that. First of all, I'm going to start with the Bot Framework application template. So if I just scroll down here, I'm going to click on Getting Started with the connector. So obviously you can review this page in your own time. It is quite thorough in terms of what it goes through. So you know, once this video is over, I'd encourage you to come back to this page and sort of read through the steps and just make sure you're comfortable with everything we've talked about. But I'm just going to jump ahead to downloading the template that we're going to be using. So if we have a look, there's a link here that I can click. This will download the bot application template. And what it's saying is we need to copy this file to this folder here. So I'm just going to open that location in Windows Explorer. I'm literally just going to drag and drop this file. To the templates folder. So what that will mean now is when we start Visual Studio up, we'll have a new option called Boss Application. You can see it in this screenshot in the website. Okay, so I'm gonna kind of move on now. We've installed the template. So the next thing we need to do is install the Bot Framework Channel Emulator. Now, the channel emulator is a tool that you can use to simulate or emulate a channel. So, you know, the channel being something like Skype or Facebook Messenger or, you know, SMS or email, you know, the emulator serves the same purpose. So it's a way to kind of interact with your bot without having to deploy your bot out into the wild. So again, we've got a link here. I'm just going to click that link. This is asking me to effectively kick off the installation. So I'm just going to click install. I'm going to run setup. And that's going to install the emulator for me. Okay, so that'll take a moment to install. But once that's up and running, we'll effectively have a test harness that we can use when we're developing our bot. Okay, so while that's going, I'm going to come back into here, and I'm actually going to start the process of registering my bot. Okay, so again, on the top, if you click on register a bot, click on sign in, and just sign in with your Windows 5 account. So I click register a bot, and this takes me to a page where I can effectively define a new bot. So I'm gonna give it a name, a handle, and a description. So we'll say bots 28/11/16. We'll use today's date. I'm gonna use the same name for the bot handle. The bot handle is effectively the thing you see when you talk into the bot over Skype or Facebook Messenger. It's the handle of the bot in that environment. Okay, and then obviously if I was creating a real bot, I'd put in some descriptive text there as well. So next thing we need to do is we need to define our messaging endpoint. So this is where the bot application can be reached by bot framework. So I'm going to use Azure. So Azure gives me this publicly accessible URL, which I can configure Bot Framework to talk to. Okay. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create an app ID and a password. So just click on that link and it starts a wizard. Okay, and it's generated an app ID for me. I click the button and this is going to generate a password as well. So just a general tip, the first time you create your bot, you register it, you're going to need three pieces of information in order to get the thing working. One of them is the password that we just generated here. The other piece of information is the name. So I'm going to grab that from here as well. And just keep a record of that. And then the last thing is the app ID as well. So we've got name, app ID, and password. Okay. So just keep a record of them. Just so that when you start to develop your bot application, everything's you have all the information you need. So I'm going to click confirm that I agree to terms of use and the code of conduct. I'm just going to click register, and that's going to go off and create all the plumbing in bot framework for me to host a bot. Okay, so I'm going to close that. Next thing I'm going to do is going to start up Visual Studio. So if I create a new project, if I search for bot, select bot application, and then I'm going to use the same name as I used when I registered my bot, just for consistency. Click OK. And that's going to go off and create a project structure. Effectively, it's going to create me a ASP.NET MVC Web API project. Okay. So if we just have a look, you know, if you've ever seen Web API before, you should be familiar with things, you know, concepts like API controllers. And then we have, you know, handling HTTP post over this relative URL. I'll talk you through the code in more detail as we run the bot, but I just wanted to kind of show you what this looks like. So before we can actually run it, we just need to provide a little bit of configuration. So if I double click on the web config, we have these three pieces of configuration that we need to fill in. We have the ID, we have the app ID, and then we have the app password. So if you remember back to registration, we kept those pieces of information as we were entering them. So again, I'm just going to copy and paste these values from here to here. And that's it. That's literally all we need to do. Okay. So I'm going to set a breakpoint in this HTTP post just so we can sort of see what's happening when we're testing. I'm going to minimize a few of these windows just so you can sort of see. So let me set the breakpoint there. And I'm just going to press F5 and run it. Okay. So the bot's running now. We're using IIS Express just to host it. We can run the channel emulator to test this. So a couple of things to check. So just double check that the URL here matches the URL on here. You can see in this instance, the port name was wrong. So I've just fixed that there. Couple of pieces of information you need to provide. Again, it's this app ID, which we already have. So again, just copy and paste it there. And again, the app password, which we just copy and paste in there as well. Okay, so that's all configured. So now we've got our channel in place, the emulator that we're using. So I can type a message and that will fire up the Visual Studio debugger. At which point I can step through this code. So I'm saying if the activity type is a message, activity being the thing that's passed into the controller by bot framework. So bot framework takes care of this for you. It provides a nice convenient wrapper for, you know, a lot of the sort of information that you'd need to handle. So you can see things like, you know, you can see which channel the messages come from. You can see who sent the message. You can see, you know, the time it was sent. You can see the type of activity, whether it was a message, whether it was a, you know, whether the user was typing something. You can also see the text that was sent as well. So I'm just going to step through the code. So what we're doing here is we're creating a new connector client, and the connector client is the thing that we're going to use to respond to the user. So we create a new connector client with the URL that was inside the activity that was passed in. This is effectively the way the bot can communicate with the channel. And then we're just generating a message. We're saying you sent activity.txt, which was however many characters. Okay. Then finally we just send that back to the channel. I'm just going to press F5 and complete that through. And you can see there you sent hello bot, which was 9 characters. Okay, so I'm just going to send another message just to sort of demonstrate that you have the full sort of Visual Studio development experience here. So I just type hello bot, and again I'm going to step through this. And instead of using the code that we've already defined, I'm going to use the immediate window to reevaluate the code. So I'm going to basically generate a new response in the debugger. So I'm going to say hello from debugger. Okay. I'm going to press F5 again, and we should hopefully see that message come through to the bot framework emulator. So that's kind of wraps up the development story for registering a bot, having a look at documentation, configuring the bot code in Visual Studio, and then actually testing it using the channel emulator. You can see it's quite a compelling story. You have full Visual Studio debugger support. So it's really easy to kind of find and diagnose issues if they come up.